It was a miserable November day, and it was drizzly rain, the sort of drizzle that clings to your coat and hangs on to you and gets you absolutely soaking wet. It was Catrice's second birthday that day.
Mm-hmm.
We'd returned from a three-week garrison exercise, and so the whole garrison appeared at early morning Saturday the 28th of November 1981
mm-hmm.
in the area of the Naffy. What a lot of people didn't know was that the German college also next door had an opening day.
Right.
And a painting day. So you can well imagine what it was like. The footfall was 10 times the norm
mm-hmm.
and the consequences were that I had to drop Sharon, Catrice and Sharon's oldest sister Wendy
mm-hmm.
off in the car. I then had to continually drive round in a circle until such times as somebody left the complex so that I could park the car up.
Right, okay.
I then parked the car up and was aware that time was marching on and realised that something wasn't quite right.
Mm-hmm.
So I then walked into the Naffy complex.
Okay.
And I was walking from one complex to another, but all under the same roof. I happened to pass the office where the manager's office door was and noticed that Sharon was sat there crying and her sister Wendy stood next to her.
Okay.
I then walked in and I was then informed that Catrice had gone missing. So my immediate response, your army training kicks in. I grabbed everybody that I knew from my regiment
mm-hmm.
and anyone else that knew me, and we'd done a search outside of the complex and inside of the complex
mm-hmm.
and we informed the Royal Military Police.